part of all of the work that we have done with our private development partners and the other stakeholders is fundamentally getting back to the basics, building on the core understanding that African-American people can be as successful, indeed more so, if given a decent environment and decent opportunities. All people can be successful. All people are children of God with unlimited human potential. If you have low standards and low expectations, you're creating a formula for failure. For God's sake, let's not do things that fail. And concentrating families in poverty fails. I think when we think about these issues, so often what the larger society does is that there's something wrong with the people. That's why they haven't been successful. No, there's nothing wrong with the people. There's something wrong with us people who have the responsibility to do better by the larger society. That's not to say that 100% of the people are going to be successful, but we should design it that way. And we shouldn't be writing people off because of circumstance. So I'm very pleased with the work that we've done to date because we have been going directly at that issue. This is how I think about it. Okay, so the first wave was ending slavery. The second wave was the civil rights movement in terms of dealing with all the Jim Crow policies and racial prejudice and all of that. And we're still working on all of those things. But the third wave is what's going to make all of this sustainable. And that is tapping into the unlimited human potential of the human beings. And so that means going directly at the causes of poverty, structural poverty. So positioning people to be empowered based on their capacity, that we've got to focus on helping people overcome those things that have in the past created dependencies. Being laser focused on higher caliber education. That is something that we are uniquely responsible for, all of us, not just the teachers and the schools, but everybody in society is involved in education. So, you know, how we vote on issues, how we hold the systems accountable, and not just the school system, but the entire society. If we came together and decided that every child should have a world-class education, not wealthy children should have world-class education, but every child should have a world-class education, we could do it. So this is all about breaking the cycle of intergenerational poverty. So, I mean, that's what the third wave has got to be about. We've got to change our mindset. We've got to do things that are going to ensure that our standards and expectations don't creep to such a low level that we are, over the long term, destroying people. This is creating opportunity, access, and success so that it is hardwired into all of the folks, all of the people. The real measurement has to be, how are the children faring as they grow up? Not just some children, but all children as they come through. But if our success indicator is showing anything below 98, then we fail. So forget whether it's liberal, conservative. I think it's common sense. But let's put it this way. I've been very passionate about the work because I really care. Has the work been perfect? No, but it has been sincerely focused and moving in a direction that I think will, if you take the long view, have tremendous payoff. Until we can see that that's happening just as a matter of course, then our work isn't done. GP.
Your hands again. church up in here. Come on, check. Conqueror. Can I get a witness up in here?